Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Dr. Dabowski. Welcome to part two of my Statement of Cash Flows lecture that will deal with the investing and financing sections. And the investing and financing sections of the Statement of Cash Flows. In the last lecture, we covered the operating section of the Statement of Cash Flows in our last video, and we saw how to reconcile from net income, which is an accrual-based measure, to net operating cash flows, which is a cash basis measure. We will now continue to learn more about the Statement of Cash Flows and look at the other two sections in more detail, the investing section and the financing section, which will be the focus of today's video. Investing cash flows generally involve lending money and collecting loans, buying and selling of long-term assets like property, plant, and equipment, and then buying and selling investments that are not classified as cash equivalents. Cash equivalents are those very short-term cash or near-cash items that are convertible to cash generally in 90 days or less, like a certificate of deposit. In summary, investing activities include cash transactions dealing with long-term assets and short-term investments. So generally, that's everything that gets reported in the investing section, only if it deals with long-term assets, buying and selling of property, plant, and equipment, disposing of property, plant, and equipment, buying and selling of short-term, let's say, available-for-sale securities, which are short-term investments. Those types of things are the only things that are reported in the investing section. The financing section includes or captures where money is being borrowed and where the company is repaying its debt. So obtaining cash from owners by issuing stock or also by paying dividends. So in summary, the financing activities include cash transactions dealing with long-term liabilities, issuance of new long-term debt, bonds payable, and or issuing new common stock or preferred stock to investors. These are the only things that are included in the financing section. And of course, dividend payments also get reported in the financing section. So what is the relationship between the statement of cash flows and the balance sheet? Well, current assets is a balance sheet classification for assets that are convertible into cash within 12 months or less. The cash transactions reported in the statement of cash flows all are handled via the operating activity section, which we looked at in our last video. Long-term assets are investing activities that are captured and reported in the statement of cash flows. Current liabilities are operating activities and are reported in the operating activity section of the statement of cash flows. Long-term liabilities are financing activities. So we're now seeing that the two major components of investing activities is the long-term assets, and in the financing, the major component comes from the long-term liabilities. And then obviously your stockholders' equity accounts, which are balance sheet classifications, are also, any changes are reported in the financing section as well, buying and selling of new stock and payment of dividends. So let's determine, and let's see if we understand and determine which of each of the following transactions would be classified as investing or financing cash flow and whether it represents an inflow or an outflow of cash. Now let's kind of look at this very carefully here. Purchased land with cash. So what type of an account is this? We purchased, number one, and we purchased land. So what type of this? Is this a current asset or is land a long-term asset? Oh, it's a long-term asset. So therefore, you know that long-term assets get reported in which section, investing or financing? That's correct. It would be probably investing. And would this be an inflow or an outflow? Well, the sight word purchased, which tells us that we used cash, so likely that would be an outflow of cash. So let's see if we're right. So we'll take this one a little slower. Type of account would be long-term asset. It is investing, and it is an outflow, so we were right. So let's go on to the next line. Borrowed cash from the bank. Borrowed is a sight word. What type of an account is it when you borrow cash from the bank? Well, it's a long-term liability. So that gives you the clue of which section of the statement of cash flows it should be reported in. Long-term liabilities are reported in the financing section. And since we borrowed, cash came in, so it was an inflow. We paid cash dividends. Dividends are stockholders' equity. Stockholders' equity changes or payment of dividends are always reported in the financing section, and since we paid it, cash went out. It's an outflow or a negative number on the statement of cash flows. Purchasing a building with a note. Building and a note, that means it's a long-term asset, right? And it's a liability because we incurred a liability to purchase the building. So this means that this would repeat neither because we financed it and there was no flow of cash because we borrowed the money to finance the asset. So there's no inflow, there's no cash coming in, and there's no cash going out. It's a finance, it's a non-cash transaction that would be reported in the supplemental disclosures. We sold a machinery for cash. Machinery is a long-term asset. Therefore, it's investing, and since we sold it, it's an inflow of cash. Cash came in. If we repay amount owed to a bank, that's a long-term liability. Long-term liability is reported in the financing, and since we repaid it, it's an outflow. We lent cash to an employee. We lend cash. That's a long-term asset. It's investing, and since we lent the money, the cash went out. It's an outflow. You issue common stock for cash. That's an equity, right? And equities go in the financing section, and that's an inflow because we issued stock, so cash went up. Purchasing treasury stock. Remember, treasury stock is a contra stockholders' equity account. We purchased it, so that means it's treasury stock, so we know it's equity. And we know it's financing, and since we purchased it, we have to use our cash. The cash went out to repurchase our stock, so it's an outflow. Please review these transactions carefully. These are key to understanding the investing and financing section. A few unusual items. Borrowing cash is a financing activity, but paying interest expense on that borrowed cash, is an operating outflow. Purchases another company's stock is an investing activity, but receiving dividend revenue on that stock as an investment is an operating inflow. These are exceptions. These are things we need to be aware of. Lending cash is an investing activity, but receiving interest revenue on that lent cash is an operating inflow. All transactions that affect net income are classified as operating activities, regardless of their nature. So that's one quick way of remembering it. If it's a transaction that affects net income, generally they're going to be classified as an operating activity, regardless of their nature. Let's indicate whether the item is recorded in the operating, the investing, or financing, the OIF sections, using the indirect method. We've learned this in Lecture 1, Depreciation and Amortization goes in what section? Section 1, Operating, and we add that back. Decreases in accounts payable, remember, that is operating, and decreases in accounts payable would be a subtraction. Dividend payments, we just studied that. That's going to be financing, and that's going to be an outflow. Increases in inventory, a current asset, would be operating and it would be subtracted. Purchases of property, plant, and equipment, a long-term asset, would be what? Think. We just covered it. Investing, correct. And we purchased it, so it's in subtract. Repayment of long-term debt. It is financing. Repay is a subtraction. Net income, where does that go? Which section? Remember, that's the very top of the statement of cash flows. It's the first line we list. In the last video, we prepared that. If we issue new common stock, it's financing and added. It's an inflow. If we sold some land, it would be investing section. It's a long-term asset, and we would add it in because we sold it. It would be a cash inflow. And then cash collections from customers is Not applicable. Cash collections from customers is not either in operating and investing or in financing section. Cash collections are not reported under the indirect method. If this was the direct method, then we would report the cash collections from our customers and cash payments to suppliers. But since this is the indirect method, we take the changes in the current assets and current liabilities year over year. Well, let's present the investing and financing activities sections. Let's do this. An example. Investing, number two, purchase of equipment. That would be an outflow, and you'll notice it's in negative 800. Number seven would be also a sale of investment, would be an investing. We sold it, it would be an inflow. Notice how it's a positive number. What else goes in the investing section, 1 through 11? And number eight, right, proceeds from the sale of equipment would also be an inflow. We would therefore have a net inflow of 1,200 if we added these three up. How about for financing? Number three, right, borrowed from the bank, it's an inflow. What else? Proceeds from the stock issuance, also another inflow. Payments to long-term debt, number six, that's an outflow. Number nine, dividends paid. That's another financing cash outflow, negative number. And number 11, purchasing of treasury stock is also an outflow. Sum them up and we have a net inflow of 2,500. Example, let's say we dispose of some equipment. The original cost of the equipment was 15. The accumulated depreciation was 11. So we are looking at the equipment cost and the accumulated depreciation, and we see the book value of 4. We sold it for 3. How much would be reported in the investing activity section in each year? Notice, right, the investing section is concerned with how much cash we actually got from the sale. In year 1, what would we report? 3,000. And in year 2, we would do 7,000, and year 3 would be 2,000. It's the actual cash from the sale, the cash amount. This is the cash flow statement. What amount would be added or subtracted in the operating activity section using the indirect method? Notice it would be the gain or loss from the sale, which would affect net income. So you take the difference in the book value and the cash from the sale, and if the book value is greater than the cash, we have a loss that would be added back. If the cash from the sale is greater than the book value, we'd have a gain. We'd subtract that out. So in each year, you can calculate the relative gain or loss and then add it or subtract it depending on whether it's a gain or a loss or a gain. So we had a $1,000 loss in year 1. We would add it back. In year 2, we would subtract a $2,000 gain. And in year 3, there was no gain or loss, so we would not have to make any adjustment. Notice the gain in year 2 is subtracted out. So notice how the gain or loss is put in the operating section because it affects net income. But the cash from the sale of a disposal of a long-term asset is reported directly in the investing section for the cash amount. Well, I think that we're doing this, y'all, and I hope that this second part of this video helps you understand better the statement of cash flows. And if you don't understand it, then you can go back and watch the other part of the video. And as always, thank you for listening. Enjoy the rest of your day, afternoon or evening. Take care, everyone.